Okay, hello everyone. So this is an offshoot of the discussion about random walks. I want to cover one application which I think is very nice and very neat, and with a little bit of Mathematica skills, one can already see some very interesting results, right? So if you want to work it out analytically, you'll have to work much harder. So I want to show you this so-called first passage processes in the problem of the random walk. Okay, so as always, I will start by clearing Mathematica of any prior knowledge. So, I mean, as you can see, I've already run Mathematica, so it's showing some weird number. If it had started afresh, it would be just 1, but it's 223, but doesn't matter. So, I clear all the variable information it has. So, yeah, as you can see on the screen, so this problem pertains to, for example, that of a stock investor. Think of a stock investor who has put some money in some piece of stock at some point, and then they find that after some time the value of the stock has dropped, and so they're like, oh, why did we put this money in? At least even if it comes back to where I started, I'm willing to sell it so that I don't have any loss. You know, if I'm unable to make a profit, then let me at least not make a loss. And so the investor is hoping and praying that the stock would come back to where it started, right? So, you know, this question of whether if you model the stock prices as a random walk, if the random walk will again pass through the origin, right, or any particular point that you wish to choose, is a problem of first passage, right? So you can think of the 1D random walker who starts off at the origin and does some complicated path, and then you ask whether they come back to the origin at all, and if they do, how much time will it take, right? These are the two questions that the stock investor would be interested in. One is whether, if it is a random walk, whether it unbiased random walk, whether it will come back at all to a certain point, and if it does, what is the typical time that you would have to wait before it happens, right? So these are the two questions, and so we will model this as a pure unbiased random walk. But I mean, in reality, it's not really the correct model for the stock market. It's way more complicated than just a simple 1D unbiased random walk like here. But let's understand this question for the 1D random walk problem. We've already discussed how if you take n steps, on average you have covered a distance of order square root of n, and we looked at many ways of seeing this result and how this is a ubiquitous result and how this is connected in general to the problem of diffusive motion and so on, right? So now this question is about, does first passage happen at all? That's the first question. So the second one is the time taken for first passage. So let's numerically just generate a large number of walks and keep track of it and work out the solution. So I have broken down this problem into a bunch of things to do. So if you want, you can pause the video at various points, like here now, you know, this is problem A. You can pause the video, probably you can get a glimpse of my solution, but it's not really going to help you. You can pause the video and try to work this problem out for yourself. So suppose you say that you want to generate 10,000 random walks, unbiased random walks. We've already seen how to do this. Now find a fraction of these walks that have completed first passage for a given n steps. So let's say you keep running this random walk for n steps and you ask whether it has returned to the origin for the first time within those n steps. If it does, then you count those walks and you divide by the total number of random walks. And just make a plot of, you know, out of 10,000 random walks, how many of them have returned to the origin within n steps, and then you increase n steps, and then you keep on varying it, and you see as a function of n steps, what is the fraction of random walks which will return, right? So this will in fact give us an estimate for, you know, what would happen if for a typical random walk. We are imagining a scenario where you have like really large number of random walks, right? That is one way of thinking about what happens in a distribution. Okay, so here is my solution. If you have tried enough and if you feel that you already have a solution, you can look at my solution. Or if you feel that you have tried enough and you have given up, you can also look at my solution. But I prefer that you really work hard before, you know, one way or the other. You must make sure that you have given your best attempt before you look at my solution. So here is mine. Not necessarily the best solution, but it is a solution. And I know that it works because I have checked it. Okay, so what I do is I generate a table, and inside this I have another table, right? So this table will generate for me a random walk, right? You have seen how to generate a random walk. We have done this in the past. So I start with some, an array with just zero in it. It's just one element array. And then I'm introducing this quantity, which I'm calling fp, fp equal to zero. And then do append to this array of size, to this array, you append an minus one, the last element of this array, plus one random choice, either plus one or minus one. Okay, so here's my solution to the problem. So what I do is, I have a table of tables. Now this inside table is something that you have sort of already seen, because I am generating a random walk here, and I'm calling it num for reasons you will be evident in some time. So there is a table which contains a equal to just one element, which is just zero, right? And you have seen how this works, and I'm introducing this thing called fp. This is for fp for first passage equal to zero, and then I have a random walk, append to this an minus one plus random choice of either plus one or minus one. You go to the right or left. And now what I do is, if at some n has gone to zero, right, this n will start only from two. So at n equal to one, of course, it's already at zero, and you can clearly see that it will never be at zero for an odd number of steps. In the first step, it has to be either at plus one or minus one. Second step, it can be at the origin. Third, again, it cannot be at the origin. Fourth, it could be, and so on, right? Only even steps are possible, but that's some detail, right? So here I'm allowing n to go from two to n steps, and if a of n equal to zero, so there's an if command within Mathematica. You can look up the syntax if you're interested. A of n equal to zero, then I will put fp equal to one, right? First passage has happened basically, and then I break this. I don't want to keep doing this do loop, right? And then within this n steps, if fp happens, fp becomes one, otherwise it will remain zero. And then I just note down fp, and then I do this 10,000 times. That's my 10,000 such random walks. Then I will note down the number of steps, n steps. Then I will do total of num divided by length of num, which is actually nothing but the mean of num. I could have directly done mean of num, you will get the same answer, it doesn't matter. And then I will allow n steps to take all these values, 10, 50, 100, 200, 500, 1000, and so on, all the way up to 10,000. You can play some other set of numbers if you want. So let me go ahead and run this. It's still running. It will take a moment, and then we can look at the data. So what does I have this num. Now you know why I use num, because I have to find its mean, and then I create a whole table of this, right? Like exactly like what the problem statement described for me. Okay, so the job is done. Now I am of course going to go and plot this. I use list plot, and there you go. So I have this fraction as a function of n steps. So you see that this fraction is going to become as close to one as you want. You just have to keep on increasing n steps, right? In other words, if you are willing to wait for long enough, it seems like this probability that there is first passage is actually one. It's with, in other words, with unit probability, there is going to be first passage no matter what, right? So the stock investor would just need to wait forever for, if he's willing to wait for long enough, then there is going to be first passage. Then I was a bit hasty in saying something like forever. So let's actually ask ourselves, what is the typical amount of time that he has to wait before actually first passage happens, right? First statement is, the unbiased random walk is guaranteed to undergo first passage. Now the second statement is, what is the typical time? So that's part B. So here again, once again, you can pause the video and work this out for yourself. So in other words, what you do is generate 10,000 random walks, and for each of these random walks, you just count the number of time steps t for the random walk to return to the origin for the first time. Continue your random walk until first passage takes place, and just simply make a list of all these numbers and see what are these numbers like. Are these numbers which seem to have a nice average, or is it like, what is the distribution of this? That's what you want to play with and find out. Is this a sharply peaked distribution? Is it a wide distribution? What happens to the mean, and so on, right? So this analysis I want you to do right? So it's not very difficult. You can use the code in the previous section, and with some small tweaks, you can work this out. So I urge you strongly to pause the video, write your own piece of code, check this out, and then only look at my solution. So my solution is the following. So I will, you know, like before, I have this table starting with 0 and then append to, I will do once, only once, right? Because I want to use this while command. So while a of n is not equal to 0, I will keep on continuing this. Otherwise, the moment a of n becomes 0, I will just automatically stop. I don't want to use break like I did before. I can directly use a while loop. While a of n is not equal to 0, just append this and continue the random walk, and then n plus plus. So in order to start with n equal to 2, I generated my random walk from starting from 0, and then one step I have already generated here, and then I put n equal to 2, and then while a of n is not equal to 2, clearly when n equal to 2, a of n is guaranteed not to be 0. It's only from n equal to 3 onwards it's possible, right? So TFP, of course, will be n minus 1, right? The first step. So n and TFP are indeed related by this n minus 1. If at the nth step you reach there, the time taken is n minus 1, right? So this is just a matter of some bookkeeping. Now, if TFP happens, I will keep a record of this first passage time, and then I will do this 10,000 times, right? I am generating 10,000 random walks, and I'm keeping track of. So my part A gives me the confidence that my simulation will actually stop. I mean, in general, you don't want to put in a while loop like this, right? What if this condition is never met? And so then you may run into a loop which will never close. But my experiments with part A actually give me the confidence that I can do this, right? And I'm telling you that it's possible. So it is, eventually you are going to get this TFP. So let me go ahead and run this and show you that indeed all of these random walks will actually come back. If you keep running the simulation for long enough, it will come back. And so let me note down all this data. So let me so it's already done. So for 10,000, so now if I were to, so I can use this thing called tally of data, sort the data and then tally and put it in table form. So what it does is it tells me that, you know, TFP equal to 3 happened 4988 times, and TFP equal to 4988 times. So if TFP is the time of first passage, so in the step 1 it is at 0. So after one step it's going to be at the first. So I should just take TFP to be equal to n itself, so then it's going to be even, right? So it's something that it's not really going to substantially change the nature of the problem. You can play with this. So let's make this equal to n, right? And then we will see that it gives me a table form. So it gives me all even numbers, right? So then you have you know, all these various possibilities are there. And then if I will hide this information, and then if I do a histogram of this, then you see that actually you get a lot, you know, you get representation even for very, very large numbers, and that is the point. So that is also evident in this way of looking at the data. You see that some of these random walks actually run very, very, very long. So you see that there are 22,000. It has run for 22,000 steps before it has come back. Okay, so I noticed that some of these numbers are even and others are odd, and which seems to be an issue. And so this is perhaps some small logical fallacy in this. And so that would be a homework problem to figure this out. But in essence, this is indeed correct. So you can work this out, and then you have a histogram here. And so mean, if I were to compute this mean, I get 16.8, right? So the third part of this is to repeat this whole thing and find out whether this set of means will itself converge or not, right? And in order to do this, I have a part C associated with this. And so part C, what does it do? It says you repeat part B by just varying the number of walks and walks itself, and then you ask whether there is some convergence of this average value, right? So that's what this part C does. And so my solution, what I do is I will take all these means and then simply keep on increasing this n walks, right? So this is some code that you can look at. So here I have TFP equal to n minus 1, and then I have a list plot. So you see that. So this problem is going to take some time for it to run. Okay, so first I have to run this. It's going to be so I hit shift enter and it takes a moment. So now when it is running, I will explain what is going on. So I have a table of this. So this is the inner table is indeed what we have already seen. And then once we get this information for TFP for n walks itself, I'm taking it to be a random variable, and that I will allow it to go from 100 to 2000 in steps of 100. And now I'm ready to plot it. So there, now you see that if I were to average over 100 or 200 or 300 and so on all the way up to 2000 of this, it's actually a wildly fluctuating number, this mean of this quantity. It's not really, there's no simple order to it. And there's another way of seeing this whole thing, and that is to take the mean of, you know, a different number of these data points. If it is a quantity that is going to converge, then the more the data points, the better is the mean, and it's going to go to some converging value. But you'll see now actually that in this case it does not converge. So what I do is I will generate only one such table with 10,000 numbers in it. It's just one step. And in the second step, what I will use is I'll use this thing called take. There's a function called take which allows me to take the first n of these numbers and take the mean of them, and then I will progressively increase n from 1 all the way up to 10,000. So there you see it did this, and I don't really want to show this data, so I will suppress this. And then if I plot this, then you see that it's a wildly fluctuating quantity. If I generate this whole thing again, and then if I do this stuff again and then plot this again, once again you see that there is no simple method to it. If it were a, you know, well converging thing, you would basically get the same kind of graph every time you did it. And so this is for you to explore and find out. So the final overall take home message from this discussion is that with probability 1, there is going to be first passage to the origin or to any point that you choose, but the average time taken for first passage is actually infinity, and that's why this quantity is not a convergent quantity, this mean, right? So this is something that you should play with and try to solve all these bits for yourself, A, B, C, D for yourself, and then you will see what is going on underneath it. Okay, thank you.